Hello everybody and welcome to episode number 6 of my weekly recap series. In this series, I just try to go over all the information related to the RuneScape community this week. That includes content updates, community updates, and a few recaps on Reddit as well as a recap of the Q&A. Anyway, hope you enjoy and let's get started. So we received one content update this week. On September 27th of 2018, we received a Decanting, Withdraw X, and Bucket Pack update. So now we have improved Decanting. Before, you can only decant into 4 doses. However, with this update, with Bob Barter and Zahur, you can decant into 1, 2, 3, or 4 doses, so you can switch between them at will. And if you're decanting to 1 doses and you just need a bunch more vials, it'll automatically purchase them for you for 2 GP each from a gold stack. There's a quick mini dev blog pretty much just stating how long it took to make this, so props to mod Kiernan for taking the time to write the code for this. We've also received the Withdraw X Bank function that was on mobile and now it is on the desktop version. It's a very useful feature, so it's kind of like the Withdraw All button, except it'll be Withdraw X. So whatever you've stated as your X will automatically withdraw that amount without having to right click and withdraw or anything. You just click once. It's pretty nice. This will also work for 1, 5, or all. So all you have to do is click on the item once and you'll withdraw that amount. We've also gotten a little bit more usability when you're using deposit boxes. For items like rune pouches or coal bags or anything that has a usable interface within the bank screen, all of that has been extended now to deposit boxes. So just a nice QOL update. You can now fill your rune essence pouches without closing the bank interface, provided that you have the essence in your inventory. This will make rune crafting a little bit easier. And that little red frowny face that you've gotten so used to over the years, that is gone. And now we have the account management tab where you'll be able to see bonds, your unread messages, and be able to change your name right in the client, as well as apparently a customer support link. Who knew? The thermonuclear smoke devil has received a visual redesign, and we also have bucket packs coming into the game, so the great bucket shortage will finally come to an end. You'll be able to buy bucket packs at any of the general stores. That was it for content updates this week. Now let's have a look at some community updates. So the event schedule for RuneFest has been posted. If you are attending the event, you can go look at the exact schedule now. If it was in Canada, I would go, but unfortunately it's very far away. The old school RuneScape wiki is actually leaving Wikia. Now I am very excited for this because Wikia is just a very bad design. It has tons of ads, it's very intrusive, and I've heard a little bit backhanded and not the best. So you can have a look at what the new RuneScape wiki is going to look like. It's going to have a lot less ads for one, which is extremely nice. It's going to be a lot more mobile friendly. And most exciting of all is the wiki team and the old school RuneScape team are going to be working directly together to actually put integration to the wiki within the actual game. There was an awesome suggestion on Reddit, I'll just put it here because is relevant, of having a search function near your minimap. What it would be is just an icon you click on once, and then you click on an object in the game and it'll automatically open up the relevant Wikia page, which would just be so awesome. They also mentioned putting links to the wiki pages within the skill guides just for additional information, which I think is an excellent idea, especially since the wiki information is pretty accurate and in depth. So definitely go look at the new site if you get a chance. Next up, we have a new update for Rune Light, and one that's actually extremely useful. The Grand Exchange buy limits have been added directly onto the Grand Exchange screen, as well as the OS Buddy actively traded price. So all the information will be right under the description of the item. Also, there's a few other minor changes to this version of Rune Light. And last up here, a public service announcement for anyone who has an old RS3 account with quest points. If you have a high amount of quest points, you have the ability to roll for a new event item that apparently can be worth billions of gold sometimes. Apparently 200 mil to like 2 billion. Some sort of die. If you have an old RS3 account you're not using, now some people are getting like billions of GP and swapping it to old school RuneScape, even at like a 7-to-1 ratio. You could get upwards of 200 to 300 mil old school GP, which would be nothing to scoff at. And that is it for updates this week. So once again, this week we had a weekly Q&A, and we're just going to do a quick recap of any of the important questions. So first up, can we get multiple accounts on a single sign-in? This is directed at mobile. They said the mobile team are looking at it and want to look at it on desktop as well. What is something that players always report as a bug, but that isn't actually a bug? One is RNG, so monster drops. Fairy rings having NPCs follow the player through. Some have a 1 in 16 chance of spawning something from the area to come through. Interesting. Does Zalra have a rare chance of getting 3 items instead of scales? There was a post on Reddit the other day showing 3 unique drops that weren't scales. They said it shouldn't happen, it could be photoshopped, or it could be a third party client issue. Can we have the ability to move prayer or spells around? Are there any plans on adding this yourself or making third party clients stop? They said there's no immediate plans on stopping it. There are plans to work closer with third-party clients in the works. We can do whatever the players want. With how dated the rare drop table is, are there any plans on changing it? They said it was updated not too long ago, and you're much more likely to get something now. If something new is brought to the game that makes sense to add, it could go on the rare drop table, but they're not really looking at adding anything else to it. Can we get ground items highlighted with hover over text? They said they could if the engine team are able to help. Now, I think this one especially is important for mobile. Currently, trying to deal with a bunch of drops on the ground on mobile is extremely hard, so I think having some sort of item overlay is almost necessary for the main client, at least for mobile, and really it should have it on desktop as well. Can master scroll books be traded for a teleport to Watson or a random clue teleport? They're currently worthless and the price has crashed. They would prefer making it a Watson teleport, and 79% voted yes in a straw poll. Currently completing the Fremenic Elite Diaries reward actually makes it worse for doing Vorkath because you can't get kicked off the island. Can this be fixed? They said they might add a functionality to the banker to kick you off in the same way that the diary does. Server tick rates vary between worlds. This makes it better to do Brimhaven on certain worlds. Can this be looked into, or can you give information to players to help choose worlds? They said it was interesting and would be something to look into. Any updates on the collection log? Lenny has been doing a lot of work, currently blocked by a tech issue unfortunately. As soon as that's fixed, it's a small amount of work to do from there. Can the Amulet of Glory benefit continue when it's uncharged? Currently you get more gems per hour when you're doing the gem rock mining, and they said no. Is there any chance we could spend a lot of gold nuggets, around 500 to 1,000, and it would allow us to have the ore be noted from the sack at the Motherlode mine? Not a lot of support, unfortunately. Can the spells Spin Flax and Plank Make be made to work similarly to how the String Amulet spell works? One click to do an inventory one by one, or multiple clicks to do it faster? They said if it's not making it faster, then it could be an okay change. Are there any thoughts on buffing underused or less useful barrows features? They said it would be potentially worth looking into improving things, maybe updating the Amulet of the Damned. However, they're not a huge fan of straight buffing the Barrow's armor. And that is it for the Q&A recap. And lastly, we're going to go over some Reddit suggestions from the last week. First up here by Frickitot, we have a suggestion for a new free-to-play goblin boss. Essentially, it would be like Obor. Killing goblins will provide a 1 in 128 chance of receiving a goblin key, which can be used to unlock a door somewhere near the goblins around Lumbridge to get access to an underground room where a goblin boss is located. You could get a goblin war shield, which would fulfill the role of the offensive shield slot for free to play, as well as the goblin chainmail, which would fill the role of an offensive body slot for free to play. I think this is a cool idea, however, I feel like getting some best in slot equipment should maybe be on one of the harder free to play bosses. It would make a little more sense, because I'm assuming the goblin war boss will probably be easier than Obor or Bryatophia, but still a pretty cool suggestion. Next up, a post by Bespoken112 is another boss suggestion, is the bull. The bull would have combat stats comparable to a green dragon. Every 125 cows, Gilly Groats will call you over and present an untradeable bullfight ticket. So this would be guaranteed after 125 kills. Using the ticket on Gilly will present a warning before sending you into an instant fight with the bull. He attacks primarily with melee, but can use an unblockable charging attack with a 20 max hit. The drop table would include cowhides, jewelry, and the bull helm, which would be equal to a mithril full helm with one strength. Interesting. Another pretty cool boss suggestion for free to play. Next up, a suggestion by Napkin96. Can we get a shortcut in Shiloh Village, possibly at one of these locations? I do agree that getting into Shiloh Village is kind of a pain if you happen to be just outside the castle walls. Next up, a suggestion by Sam09 is some possible GE improvements. Now, some of this we actually got with the Rune Light update. However, what he's suggesting is having some historical information right in the client, as well as showing some information on the last sales and whatnot. I don't see this ever happening. It's just way too much dev work for the main team. However, it would be extremely useful. Next up here, we actually have a free-to-play quest suggestion by The Last Ja. It would be called One Tiny Favor. Oh no. So it would be kind of like a free-to-play version of One Small Favor. It would require 35 mining and 32 smithing to start, and the ability to defeat a level 100 monster. The rewards would be 2 quest points, 2 experience lamps giving 3,000 experience to any skill of your choice, and the ability to purchase rune axes from Bob's Brilliant Axes, as well as access to a new underground edition of the Alcarid Mine. I actually really like this suggestion. Anything related to quests is always going to be good in my books, but having a free-to-play version of One Small Favor is cool. Next up, a suggestion by Ted Devil. On mobile, would you be able to click just this orb to use your special attack? Because currently, switching tabs and using the special attack really is just not going to work, especially if you are PvPing. I don't see why not, although this orb would probably need to be increased in size as well. And the final suggestion of the episode is a buff to the Broad Bolt. Essentially, that's a little complicated, but what you need to do is at level 55 cooking, you can attach a piece of bread to the broad bolt to make a bread bolt. It can be used to heal other players by shooting them. This was a suggestion by Eddie, and I appreciate it. Anyway, guys, that is it for the weekly recap. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, don't forget to toss a video a like. I always appreciate it, and I'll see you next time.